Peace TV English, the solution for humanity.
You are never alone.
You are never alone.
Just reach into your heart and Allah is always there. You are never alone.
You are never alone.
Through sorrow and through grief, through happiness and peace.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to a new episode of Family Issues. We're still talking communication. It is all about communication, isn't it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن. What are the best ways to communicate between husband and wife? How can we develop our way of communications better to rely on details or facts or to rely more on emotions and feelings when attempting to solve a problem? What are the difficulties in communication, the obstacles, the differences between men and women? We touched on that in the previous episode, and the all-important effect of a two-way communication, a fruitful communication on the health of the family, even communication with the children, communication between father and mother and their children, and vice versa. In this episode, we're going to focus on the effect of the different types of personalities on the flow of communication. So how much the different types of personalities can contribute in the success of communication, and thus, of course, in turn, the success of the marriage and the success of society. Should we change the way of communication with each type? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. Dear brothers and sisters, time now to introduce you to Mr. Muhammad Sharafuddin, and he is the author of the book, The Sacred Bond, about marriage. He's also a personal and family trainer. Assalamu alaikum, Mr. Muhammad. Thank you for being here. Jazakumullah khairan.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi. Thank you for inviting me every time.
Thank you for being here. And we appreciate your useful input with us here on Family Issues. The introverts, yeah, and the extroverts, are there any statistics regarding their success in life, for instance, in the academic life, or statistics also on the success of which combination works better?
Well,
communication in marriage?
Actually, the introverts are about 40% of the world population. The extroverts are about 60%. The extroverts are those people who are, yani, really, they like to be all the time outside with the people, with things, in the outside world. They like to really work in a casual way. They talk always, talk loudly. They start talking before thinking. The introverts think a lot, and then they talk little. You know? So these are the basic differences between both of the two characters, the extroverts and the introverts. And actually, the success rate of the introvert or the extrovert depends on how he or she utilizes his own, or manages his own self, his or her own self.
And not whether he or she is an introvert or an extrovert.
Exactly. So there are very successful introverts and there are very successful extroverts.
Right.
And in different fields. But it's very important to understand yourself so that you can, you know, when to energize and when to right, de-energize. Because some people who are introverts are put in jobs of extroverts or doing things that are they shouldn't do, like being exposed so much to people, and this stresses them out. And if one of the two,
it's difficult to be a sales person, for instance, if you're an introvert.
Well, actually, a salesperson as an introvert, it can be there can be a sales style of asking questions and imposing some information about the product, but not speaking about yourself.
It's different to be a TV presenter if you're an introvert.
It depends. If you're somebody who will talk too much, like, you know, some talk shows, you know, you will.
Right. It will, or if you're just reading the news like a parrot.
Yeah, exactly. So okay, it depends. These casual forms are not suitable for the introverts. These official forms, you know, this, you know, structured forms, the things that they will not speak much about themselves, it's okay for the introverts.
You can't be an imam, not an imam. You can't be a khatib. who gives lectures in mosques every day and day in and day out if you're an introvert?
No, there are very strong imams who are introverts. Yani, actually, lots of imams are introverts. They don't speak about themselves. They don't speak about their experiences. Mm. Actually, three of the best trainers that I've been with were introverts, actually. Mm. They don't speak about their own experiences. Whenever they cut off trainings, they just sit on their laptops and just, you know.
Okay. So if you talk about your stories, your championships, your heroics, then you're definitely not an introvert.
Yes, that is very true. Yes,
we said that we have each of the four dichotomies. Four.
Two. Dichotomies means two poles.
Two.
Yeah.
Right.
Each one.
Okay.
Dichotomy has two types.
Two types.
So you are either an extrovert. This is one.
Okay.
So this is you are either an extrovert or an introvert.
Okay.
So you have to understand yourself well.
So there's nothing in between. Many people will tell you, I'm an introvert. No, I'm an extrovert. No, actually, I'm both.
It's to some extent there is one part of you that
prevails.
There is something like a preference, but it's a personal preference, and you know yourself well that you are better be exposed or better be with people, better work on casual. You know, this introvert type of persons, they actually like text messages or, you know, to write more than speak. Yeah, they like to have, you know, predefined, you know, time frames to be exposed to people, you know, have meetings or getting to outings. You have to manage to take a date from them. The extroverts, you can access them anytime. Come on, let's go.
Yeah, right. But the extroverts and the introverts, again, this is very, very interesting. I hope, dear brothers and sisters, you're enjoying this. Most of the people, I would assume, would tell you, I'm an extrovert with those whom I love. With those where we share together culture, experience, common stuff. But I'm an introvert if I'm put in a strange society, to me, a strange society, or with people that I'm really not really fond of.
Well, actually, let's define what is the private world for a person. The private world for a person, this is the very close friends. These are two or three, maybe. Most close friends, and these are the family, you know, the parents, the kids. Mm. So actually, the wife, you know, or these are the private setting of the world. Mm. So if he or she feels comfortable saying things and out loud in his private setting, so he or she is an introvert. Mm. The extroverts really say everything exposed, you know, out large. You know, they have maybe hundreds of Facebook friends or social network friends. They say how they feel every time and every now and then. They put their photos with their beloved ones, you know, and whatever they are doing, they are telling. They don't have much secrets. Everybody knows everything about them. You know, these are the type of extroverts world. And introverts sometimes look at it and say, hey, what are these people doing? You know,
right?
Yeah, they're as if they're, you know, exposing themselves and seeing secrets, and they're, you know, this is something that should be covered away or another.
I'm sure, by the way, that as we keep talking. The people who are watching us are saying, each minute, I'm an introvert. No, I'm an extrovert. I'm an introvert. No, so let's try to define it in the best way possible. After all, this is a man-put theory, so it could work. It's
working 97% with the people. So let's talk about it in real-life examples in marriage. Yeah. Sometimes one of the couple is an introvert and the other one is an extrovert. The extrovert looks at the life as that it is always outside the world. He or she energizes outside in the outside world, outside home, the setting of home. They like to be always with people. They always like to socialize. They like to take dinners outside. They like to really express themselves socially. They like to take the family everywhere. They like, even when they go for trips, they like to take with them, to arrange it with groups of people and friends, you know, so that they can enjoy as much outside. Mm. And this is a typical extrovert personality. The introverts really like this private setting. They like to stay at home most of the time. They like to energize at home. They like to stay in the private setting. Whenever they have a trip, they don't want to make much noise about it. They don't want to have this, you know, group therapy thing, you know, or they don't like to travel in groups, except for very privately special people who can be with them on these occasions. whenever they invite people to homes, they like to have a private setting for these people and some areas to access and other areas not to access, you know. And whenever they go to people, even their families, they just stay and play by the rules, you know. They set some rules for everything they
Let's play by the rules, Mr. Muhammad, and take a break now because we have to do it. Now we'll be back with your brothers and sisters. We're still talking about communication and the MBTI model, and especially the energy orientation here, the introverts and the extroverts. We'll be back momentarily, inshallah.
Every action depends upon its intention.
Intention sincere.
What is your intention? Why do you do what you do?
Concentration, focus, dedication, dynamic.
Every single aspect of your mind, of your soul, of your heart, is it for Allah, sincerely for Him? Or is it for something else?
Get going on how to improve your prayers.
The purpose of these talks is to counter exactly that type of behavior.
Join Abdurrahim Green.
In other words, with the outward action, there is also an inner dimension.
In Inner Dimensions of Worship. Every Wednesday at 8 p.m. and repeat telecast at 8:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة ولا شفاعة.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause. The proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK. B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. We're going to talk, inshallah, in the few minutes we have left here about examples, indeed, in marriage that can help the communication. Between husband and wife and with their children as well, and vice versa. But we're still trying to define with our dear guest, Mr. Muhammad Sharafuddin, the traits or the thing that separates introverts from extroverts. He's given us a lot of examples. And again, I'm sure that each one of you is saying, well, I'm partly this and partly that. But Mr. Muhammad says that there will be a prevailing, something that prevails in the end, even if it's by 51%.
Yes,
correct.
Exactly. So,
and there are scales or tests to measure this.
Yes, exactly. There are different tests on the internet. Actually, anyone can join the group of the Sacred Bond on Facebook, they will find a test that is really 90% accurate about it.
Okay.
So actually, the extroverts and the introverts actually, by far it's a percentage. It's something that you have a preference in. So you are maybe biased more to be an extrovert or an introvert, and this is your natural orientation. If you're this type of a party person who likes to really be exposed too much to people, to be more casual with others, so you are more an extrovert. And if you are this kind of private setting world. You like formalities. You like to have everything in written. You like to communicate with people in defined windows and really not tell everything about yourself. So you are more an introvert. Let's go back to this the type of examples that that can make challenges or in communication between.
Before the example, usually, what is it that works better? Are the opposite poles or two from the same pole? Usually.
Whatever. Actually, it's...
It doesn't, whenever, there is no rule.
There is no rule, actually. The rule is love, understanding, and having a common objective.
And getting the other in the comfort zone.
Yes.
You see, I'm learning here. Yeah. Getting the other in the comfort zone.
Exactly.
So if your partner is an introvert and you know this, get him in his comfort or her comfort zone.
Exactly.
And vice versa.
So that is the key. If you know that your partner is an introvert, for instance, it is very much important that everything he or she is telling you, that's because you are in his or her very close circle of friends, and this is because of trust.
I assume that many men in the Eastern world, which is usually more reserved, would love to have an introvert partner. It's just an assumption.
Well, actually, this is something that I believe that we are stereotyping here. Actually, there I know lots of preserved people that I know very well, that they're too much extrovert and they're excessively extroverts. They're conservative and they're excessively extroverts. They live all their life with people. And they do everything with people, and they like their wife to be engaged with them in this world of, you know, people, social, and they're very casual in what they say. And whenever there is something you do, and there are famous figures, and there are people who are my friends.
Right.
And there is also the opposite. There are so many preserved people who are introverts. They just socialize through windows with people, and they just keep their private settings, and they like their homes to be a big secret and put a lock on it. The problem is that if you're one kind and your partner is the other kind, that you try to force him or her to be your kind.
Right.
To force the rules, even if you're a male and an introvert, and you marry an extrovert, and then you force her to be an introvert like you, and set up your home as being an introvert kind of setup, this. As a secret, thing. You stop her from socializing. You stop her from doing, from meeting her female friends and her social network.
Of course, because anyway, life at home. I mean, there are things that have to be secret and have to remain a secret, as we were directed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Any percentages on this number of within males, the prevailing type is. Introvert or extrovert, and within females,
What I knew that it's 50-50.
50-50.
Yeah, if you're females, and there are 50% of the females are extroverts, 50% are introverts. It's actually 40% introverts and 60% extroverts. And it's
within each females, gender, it's 50-50.
Exactly.
So it's more related. Any relationship between the percentages and the type of society? The culture of that society?
Well, actually, no. And this is something I didn't know. But there are some cultures of societies, like the Japanese culture, for instance, or the Chinese. They don't speak too much. The culture of the society, they don't express themselves, as much. And there are some societies like the Mediterranean.
For Japanese, he is an extrovert. But globally, he's an introvert.
He is an extrovert. And he expresses himself in his cultural language, the language that is known and understood in the culture of his country. But whenever he goes to a country like Italy or the Mediterranean countries like Egypt or Tunisia or whatever, and he tries to act, he looks like a typical introvert in this country. While there are introverts in the Mediterranean countries, they act as if they are typical extroverts when they go there in these countries. But actually, they are introverts. They don't express themselves much. It depends on how much you expose yourself, how much you like to be within the people. It's not about your tone of voice, your language, your body language, and this stuff. So actually, the common challenge that we have here in our Middle Eastern countries, that we assume that most of the ladies should be after marriage to be introvert, and we have to treat it in a better way. We have to this partner that we took, and some ladies also look at their husbands that they should be always extroverts and they should always be outside home. They always should be networking and socializing, and they should be sociable, and they should be expressing themselves and really look heroic outside you know, and this is not proper for all men.
Let's invest the few minutes we have now in the examples that teach us how we should deal when we try to communicate between introverts and extroverts, and fatal mistakes we should always avoid.
Okay, so actually, if you have your partner as an extrovert and he or she wants to have excessive time outside home, you shouldn't keep him beside you because you're an introvert and you need him beside you. And you should balance between, the extrovert should balance between his staying outside home and being inside the circle, the private circle
of the
introvert.
There will be a process of compromise here.
Exactly. Also, the extrovert shouldn't force the introvert to be always with him in the social networks he's in. The other thing that's related to a communication between both parties, if the introvert tells anything to the extrovert, it shouldn't be exposed outside, you know. And this is something that the extroverts should keep everything said to them from introverts as secrets. You got their trust, so you should keep it. And the other thing that the introverts shouldn't really come on the partner, the extrovert partner, talking about him or herself. This is something that will make them really comfortable and really. You shouldn't hold them talking about themselves, but they should hold them talking about their relationship And if my partner is an extrovert and he wants to talk about himself, it's okay. Mm. But I can really ask him not to talk about me or our relationship because this is our private world.
But he or she can talk about herself. That's a common mistake. It always happens, by the way. This fatal mistake we should avoid. Yeah. This happens a lot.
Yeah.
It happens a lot.
You should talk about yourself, but not about your relationship.
Right.
And actually keep the family secrets alone.
Right.
The other thing is related to visits. If you are having visits at home and there is an introvert, one of the partner of the couples is an introvert or something, you should really ask him to set up himself or herself for this visit, to set up where exactly the visitors will be allowed to be in and where not to be allowed. This can be awkward for the extroverts. The extroverts
close by this hypothetical. But I think it's confusing, at least for me.
Why?
Okay. I am an introvert with those whom I don't like. I'm an extrovert with everybody I like, whether it is my children, my father, my mother, my wife, my friends. But if it's somebody I don't like, I'm an introvert with him. But I'm an extrovert with everybody I love or I like. So where will I find myself here? How can you say that I'm... introvert or extrovert from this perception?
It depends. If you're talking before you think, this is an extrovert type. If you don't talk much, if you like to go within, whenever you enter a social network or something like this, you just go in and get along with people easily, this is an extrovert. The introvert normally goes with those
if
two
the people
or three.
Are from my same culture, if these people, for instance, are... Shiuch at a charity group in a mosque, for instance, I might get along with them. If it's a group who are dancing disco or something, I won't. So again, I like these people. I don't like these people. These, have a common culture with me. These don't.
I'm telling a party that you belong to, that you normally belong to. Mm. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. But there are strangers, how you deal with strangers, how you deal with the outside world. Do you talk much about yourself? Mm. Do you like to express yourself when you're with anybody easily? Do you find it comfortable even to talk about yourself, to talk about your own secrets, your status? You are okay, you're happy, you're not happy, Is it easy for you to do it? This is an extrovert type. Mm. The introverts, normally, they don't care much about, communicating their own things. They like to listen more. Do you really like to sit and just listen from others, to probe others and let them talk and you speak?
Which of the two types is more self-confident? And don't tell me it's 50-50.
No, it depends.
Or there is no rule.
You can be a self-confident person. You're an extrovert because you're an extrovert and you're using this muscle correctly. And or if you're an introvert and you are really excelling.
So you don't even have to talk about yourself because you're...
It's self-confidence doesn't mean that
there's no relationship between.
Yes, no.
Unfortunately, that's all the time we have. It was very interesting. I hope, dear brothers and sisters, you also enjoyed this episode. We're going to talk, inshallah, in the upcoming episodes with Mr. Muhammad Sharafuddin. about the remaining dichotomies. And maybe also continue to tackle the introverts and extroverts and the way it affects the communication. I mean, after all, again, we say it's all about communication. Successful communication, two-way communication, would lead to a successful house, thus a successful society at large. Thank you very much. Jazakumullah khairan, Mr. Muhammad. Wishing to see you soon, inshallah. Thank you, dear brothers and sisters, for watching us. Until we meet again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
You are never alone.
You are never alone.
Through sorrow and through grief, through happiness and peace, you are never alone. So now, as you long for your past, prepare for your future, but knowing nothing's gonna last. You see, this life is but a road, a straight and narrow path to our final abode.
Dialogue. Discussion. Debate. Rebuttal. Conclusion.
Eliminate misconceptions about religion. Get enlightened.
Witness Dr. Zakir Naik in a battle of words in Crossfire every Saturday at 8:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 12:30 p.m.